Hello everyone, Alex here from wornoffkeys.com, and in this video, we're going to be showing you how you can retrieve secrets from AWS Secrets Manager. This is often useful if you have some type of password, API key, or some type of login URI for a database of some kind, and you want to be able to access that on a AWS Lambda, for example. So to get started, I have an empty folder here. I'm navigated to that folder within my console. I'm going to run npm init-i to initialize our project, and I'm going to create a new file called index.js. We're going to start things off by importing the AWS SDK, and then we're also going to install that with npm install AWS SDK. We're then going to create a main function that'll be an asynchronous function, and it's going to have an event parameter. And for now, we're going to console log what the event contains. This is assuming that this is going to be ran inside of AWS Lambda, and so Lambda will provide some information if need be. We're going to return an empty string for now, and we're going to give Lambda access to this main function with exports.handler equals main. So if I save this, and if I open my package.json, we're going to go ahead and paste in a test script. You'll be able to find this script in the video description. This is from a previous video I made. So now if we save this, we can run npm run test. And it'll run this function as if it was a Lambda function. So we can close out of this, and we're going to want to create a new function called getSecrets. And this is going to be an asynchronous function, and it's going to have one parameter, which is going to be a secret ID. And this is going to return a new promise that has, a resolve and reject. And we're now going to want to create a new SM, which is going to be a new AWS.secrets manager. And we have to pass in the region which our secrets are stored. Mine will be stored in US East 1. Now if we go over to AWS under the secrets manager, we can store a new secret. We're going to select other type, which is API key. We're going to say API key, and we're going to go to a UUID generator to generate an actual UUID. We can copy this. Obviously, you would fill this with actual information. For now, we're going to skip most of the extra steps, and we're just going to get this set up so we don't need tags or anything like that. So the secret key can be test prod secrets. We're going to have different secrets for our production environment and our testing environment. So we can go ahead and click on next. We're going to not enable an automatic rotation. We can click on next. And then here under the sample code, we see some examples of how to actually load the secret. However, we're going to just write our own. We can click on store. And then we see it right here, test prod secrets. If we click on this, we click on retrieve secret value. We can see that we have the API key, which is what we have right here. Now, if we go into our code, we're going to want to actually load in the secret now. So we're going to call sm.getSecretValue. We're going to pass in the secret ID. And there's going to be a callback with error and result. If there's an error, we're going to reject with the error. Otherwise, we're going to resolve with the result. And then in the main function, we can return getSecrets. And so we're going to pass in a string here. So we're going to assume that these are coming from environment variables. If process.environment.prod is a thing, we're going to say test prod secrets. Otherwise, we're going to be calling test dev secrets. So we can go ahead and save this, and I'm actually going to create some dev secrets. So I'm going to generate a new UUID. We're going to copy this. We're going to go back to our secrets, and we're going to store a new secret. So we're going to select a new type here. This will be called API key, and then we're going to paste in the new UUID. Next, this will be called test dev secrets. We're going to skip through this, and we're going to store the secret. So now test dev secrets exists, and if we click on this, we can retrieve the value and we see our new UUID. So if we go back over here, because test.environment.prod doesn't actually exist, it'll default to test dev secrets. So we can save this and we can run it with npm run test. Okay, so I just realized an error. This should be inside of its own object. So if we save this and run it again, we now see some information. We see that there's a secret string object here. So if we resolve, we're going to want to resolve result.secretString, and we're also going to want to parse this as JSON. So now I can save this, we can run it, and we get the API key. So we could destructure this like this, and then we could return the API key specifically. And if we run this, we should get the direct API key that we want. Oops, I have to wait for this to work. There we go. So now we get our API key for our dev secrets. So now we're going to go ahead and turn this into an actual Lambda function. So we're going to go to services, going to type in Lambda. We're going to create a new function. This one will be called get secrets. And we also need to create a new role in order to actually access Secrets Manager. So we're going to start off by creating a new policy. The service will be Secrets Manager. The actions under read will be get secret value. And the resource we want to specify is this secret arn right here. We're going to add the arn and we're just going to paste right into here. And we want to add another arn. So we go back to our secrets and go to the production secrets. If we copy this, we want to paste that in right here. So now we have access to both the dev and the production secrets. We can review the policy. This one will be get test secrets. Going to create the policy, and I had to create a role to attach this to. So we can go to roles and create role. We're going to select Lambda because that's where we're using it. We're going to go to permissions. We're going to search get test secrets. We're going to select the policy we just created. We're not going to add any tags. We're going to name this whatever we named our Lambda function, which is just get secrets. Now we can close that. We can go to create or choose or create an execution role. We can use an existing role. And because we created it after this page was loaded, we can click on the refresh button and we can type in get secrets. We can then create the function and we can copy this code here. Because we only have AWS installed, we don't actually need to upload the node modules at all. So we can simply copy this right here. We can do control S to save in the inline console and we can click save right here. So now I'm going to configure a test event. We're not going to have anything in here, and we're just going to call this test. If we create this and we click on test to actually run the event, we then see we have our development API key. So now if we go down to our environment variables, we can manage environment variables and we can add a new one. This one will be called prod. We can set this to any type of true value. So it could be any type of string. It could be yes or true or one or anything that isn't a blank string. We're just going to call it true for now. We're going to click on save. And if we keep in mind that the development one starts with 9F, and if we click test, we now get 8F, which is the production key. So this is useful when adding environment variables if you're going to deploy this to a new version, which I'll explain in a future video. However, this is how you would retrieve secrets that you want to be able to use, such as API keys or whatever it might be, from within a Lambda function. Thanks for watching this AWS tutorial. If you need help or have a video request, be sure to leave a comment down below or ask in the Warnoff Keys Discord, which can be found in the video description. If you want to learn more about AWS, consider clicking on one of the videos you see on your screen now.